So let us begin with chapter 2, polynomials. Let us move on to the next topic, that is remainder theorem. So here is the statement. So if P of x is any polynomial of degree greater than or equal to 1 and a be any real number, and if P of x is divided by this linear polynomial x minus a, then the remainder is P of a. Slightly complicated to understand, but I'll give you a simple example, then it will be clear for you. So if P of x is any polynomial of degree greater than or equal to 1, so we have to consider some polynomial. Suppose there is a polynomial P of x of degree greater than or equal to 1. Degree greater than or equal to 1 means the degree can be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we are not supposed to take any constant polynomial. So let me assume x square plus 3x minus 4 as P of x. Now this is P of x and this degree is greater than or equal to 1, because I can say the degree of this polynomial is 2 over here. That is, the highest power is 2. And if this is further divided by a linear polynomial x minus a. Linear polynomial x minus a means x minus a, where a can be any real number. So say for example x minus, I'm taking any number instead of a, say for example I'm taking 2, then the remainder is P of a. That means if I have taken x minus a, here our a is 2, then the remainder will be P of 2. Then the remainder will be P of 2. So the statement is, if this polynomial is divided by x minus a, that is, if this polynomial is divided by x minus 2, then the remainder is P of 2. Then I have to just find out the value of P of 2. So if I take P of 2 over here, I'll get further 2 square plus 3 into 2 minus 4. So which will further give me, 2 square will give me 4 plus 3 2s are will be 6, and this is minus 4 over here. So I can write down minus 4. So plus 4 and minus 4 is ultimately going to get cancelled, and the answer is 6. That means we can say that when this polynomial x square plus 3x minus 4 is divided by x minus 2, the remainder is 6. That is nothing but P of 2. That is nothing but this P of 2. Now I'll give you one more example of this. Find the remainder when x square minus 5x plus 3 is divided by x minus 2. So we are supposed to find out the remainder when this polynomial is divided by this polynomial. So if you observe properly, if P of x is a polynomial of degree greater than or equal to 1, so can we say the degree of this polynomial is greater than or equal to 1? Yes, the degree of this polynomial is 2, which is greater than or equal to 1, and a is any real number. And if P of x is divided by x minus a, so this x minus a is nothing but x minus 2 in this case. So this is x minus a. So we can say that the value of a over here is 2. Then the remainder is P of a. That means the remainder is P of 2. So P of 2 will be the remainder. It was x minus 2, so P of 2 is the remainder. If it is x minus 3, then P of 3 will be the remainder. If it is x minus 4, P of 4 will be the remainder. So let us move further. So here is the solution. First of all, let me take this polynomial. Let me assume this polynomial as P of x, because the polynomial is in x. So P of x is equal to 4x square minus 5x plus 3, and it is divided by x minus 2. Therefore, we know that P of 2 is the remainder. That means we have to substitute 2 instead of x. So wherever we see x, we are just going to put 2 in that case. So P of x is 4x square minus 5x plus 3. So P of 2 will be 4 into 2 square minus 5 into 2 plus 3, which is further going to give me 2 square is 4, 4 4 is 16, 5 2 is 10 plus 3. 16 minus 10 will give me 6, and 6 plus 3 is going to give me 9. So P of 2 will be 9. That means 9 is the remainder. So we can say when 4x square minus 5x plus 3 is divided by x minus 2, we get the remainder as 9. How we got that? We got that just by substituting the value of x equal to 2. Now let me give you one more example. Say I change this. I'll change this part and I'll change this one. What if I have the same question as 4x square minus 5x plus 3 is divided by x plus 2? Let me just make it plus instead of minus. So what if it was asked 4x square minus 5x plus 3 is divided by x plus 2? Now, since we have x plus 2, we know that whenever the polynomial is x minus a, p of a is the remainder. That means when it was x minus 2, we write down p of 2 is the remainder. So if it is minus 2 over here, we write down p of 2 is the remainder. If I am having x plus 2, then we write down p of minus 2 is the remainder. So p of minus 2 will be the remainder. If there is plus 2 over here, then we take p of minus 2 as the remainder. If there is minus 2 over here, then we take p of 2 is the remainder. So if there is x plus 2, then we'll consider p of minus 2 as the remainder. So again, if it was plus x plus 2, I'll just solve it. We'll say that let this p of x be equal to 4x square minus 5x plus 3. So if x plus 2 is the divisor, then p of minus 2 is the remainder. So just substitute p of minus 2 over here. You can solve it further. You get 4 into minus 2 square minus 5 into minus 2 plus 3, which is going to give me further. I know that minus 2 square is 4 and 4 for the 16. So I'll get 16 over here. Minus minus is going to give me plus 5 to the, it will be 10 plus this last number is 3. So I have to add all 3 of them. I'll get 16 plus 10 is 26. 26 plus 3 will give me 29. Therefore 29 will be the remainder if it is divided by x plus 2. So you have to just remember one thing: when it is x minus a, p of a is the remainder. When it is x plus a, p of minus a is the remainder. Let us see some more examples. Now let us move on to few questions based on remainder theorem that are in exercise 2.3 NCERT. So here is the first question. Find the remainder when x cube plus 3x square plus 3x plus 1 is divided by x plus 1. So this is a polynomial in x having degree greater than equal to 1. That is, the degree of this polynomial is 3. And this is divided by a linear polynomial x plus 1, which is like your x minus a. It is divided by x plus 1. So by remainder theorem, we know that when x cube plus 3x square plus 3x plus 1 is divided by x plus 1, p of minus 1 is the remainder. So p of minus 1 will be the remainder. As there is plus 1 over here, we take p of minus 1. We have to take the opposite sign. If it was minus 1, we would have taken plus 1. So p of minus 1 is the remainder. So we are supposed to substitute x is equal to minus 1 in this particular polynomial. So we consider this polynomial as p of x. So p of x is x cube plus 3x square plus 3x plus 1. And we are going to substitute x as minus 1 to get the remainder. So we substitute x is equal to minus 1. So in the next step, instead of x, that is minus 1. So minus 1 cube plus 3 into minus 1 square plus 3 into minus 1 plus 1. So if we move further, we know that minus 1 cube is minus 1. Minus 1 square is 1. And 3 ones are 3. 3 into minus 1 will give me minus 3 plus 1. So minus 3 and plus 3. So plus 3 and minus 3 is going to get cancelled. So we get minus 1 plus 1. Again minus 1 plus 1 is going to get cancelled. And we are going to get 0. So we get 0. Therefore we say that the remainder is 0. Now we can check your answer by long division method as well. So let us see how. Here is the entire long division process for you. So you can clearly see that the remainder is 0 at the end. So since the remainder is 0, we can say that our answer is correct. So find the remainder when x cube minus ax square plus 6x minus a is divided by x minus a. So this is our polynomial whose degree is greater than or equal to 1, we can say, because the degree over here is 3, highest power is 3. is divided by x minus a. So we know that when it is will be, we know that when it will be divided by x minus a, p of a will be the remainder. So p of a will be the remainder. That means wherever we see x, we are going to substitute a. So by remainder theorem, we know that when x cube minus ax square plus 6x minus a is divided by x minus a, p of a will be the remainder. So p of a is the remainder. So p of a is the remainder. So let us see what happens when we substitute a. So p of x, that is instead of x we are going to put a, will become a cube minus a into a square plus 6 into a minus a. So this will be a cube. A square into a will give me a cube, because here there are two a's, here there is one a. So overall 2 plus 1 will give me 3 a's plus 6 a minus a. A cube will get cancelled ultimately. Then you'll get 6 a. Then you'll get 6 a minus a. 6 a minus a means 6 a minus 1 a. So 6 a minus 1 a will give me 5 a. So 5 a is the remainder.